Hi. What if there was a practice that you could do, a habit that you could cultivate that would create a better relationship between you and food, you and yourself, you and other people, maybe you and God? Would you want to know about it? Would you want to do that? Today I'm going to talk about that with you real briefly. Hi, my name is Paula Carper, and I am a registered dietitian and women's health strategist. And I'm a little hoarse today because I've been nursing a little bit of a cold. And if you'll bear with me, I'll get through this really quickly. I was making videos this morning for my private clients, and I was sharing something in one of the videos, and I thought, this video is a little bit long, and I don't really want to share it with everyone. Because not all of the information is relevant to the people that are following me on social media. But I did want to share a little bit about what I shared in that video, and that is this. What if gratitude for your food and expressing gratitude for the food that you eat could improve your relationship with food and with yourself and with other people and even with God? It's a question I like to ask. It's a question I think that has a good answer and has some positive impact on our behaviors and our thoughts and our thoughts and our behaviors. So I want to share with you a little bit today about what I shared in that video. And that is this, that I think that it's really important to create an environment around our eating and nourishing of our bodies that is healthy, that's positive, that helps us to develop a better relationship with ourselves, with our bodies, with our food, and with those around us. And so it's really important to create rituals around that, create practices and habits that help us to have that positive reflection and thought process while we're eating, and whenever we're dealing with food and preparing food for ourselves and for our families. So I would pose to you today that that expressing gratitude for food that's been prepared for you, food that you're preparing for yourself or your family, foods that you are just, snacking on. There are ways that you can cultivate a habit of expressing that gratitude. So one of the things that I like to think is that it would be really hard to express gratitude towards someone who is hurting you, someone who is doing something that's hurting you. And so I think that it would be really difficult to express gratitude for foods that we know are hurting us when we eat them. So that might include, some processed foods or junk foods that you might have on your list of things that you just love, your guilty pleasures. And those are things that that we probably all have. And we like to think that they're so good for us, that they make us feel so good. But if we really think through the process and we really understand how those foods don't help us to reach the goals that we have, especially when we have goals around our health, and around nutrition, it's really important to understand that it would be really hard that to give gratitude over and over and over, give thanks to God, thanks to someone who prepared the food for you. And it doesn't mean that you have to reject stuff that people want to share with you for hospitality reasons, but just it would be really hard to over and over express gratitude for something that you know is hurting you. On the other hand, when you're eating foods that are nourishing your body, when you're preparing foods that are nourishing your body, when foods are being prepared for you that are nourishing for your body. Certainly, it would be easier to express thanks when you understand how these things connect to your goals and what you're trying to accomplish. But it also can help you in your relationship with other people, because if you're relating better to the food that you eat and you're relating better to yourself, And you're also giving thanks to those around you, whether it's a farmer who grew your food or raised your food, whether it's someone who prepared the food that you're eating, whether it's a server at a restaurant. Giving thanks to those people, expressing thanks, is a really important part of not only having better relationships, but also having a better life, because it's a positive experience for everyone involved. So I just wanted to leave you with that thought about a practice of self-care that is spiritual, but is also going to have a big impact on your mindset. And if you're not doing that in your daily life, I would love to challenge you to do it in your daily life. It doesn't matter if it's before a meal, whether it's while you're preparing it, or after you've eaten, or even during a meal or snack. Having some sort of small practice where you set aside the time and the space to acknowledge and thank, whether it be God or someone else who has been involved in raising, growing, or preparing that food, or getting that food to your table and into your body in some way. I think it's a great practice, and I'd love to challenge you to do it, whether it be once a day to start or at every meal, doesn't really matter. Just do it. I'm Paula Culper. And I'm grateful that you've let me come into your day today to share this information with you, because I know that it'll help you. Have a great day.